I'm from the 5 and the 10. I'm from the 5 and the 10.
Welcome back, High Area. Today is a special episode. We are going to be reviewing the Viola brand by Al Harrington. And today we're going to be doing a little bit of a vlog. We're going to be checking out Chase Center. But before we check out Chase Center, we're going to review some of this Viola OG. We're going to see how it hits. Right now, we're actually in the old stomping grounds here of the Warriors. We're at the Oracle Arena, formerly known as the Oracle Arena, now the Oakland Arena. But we're going to smoke this on some of the grounds that Steph pretty much built. Rick Barry, Chris Mullin, Run TMC, just to name a few. And this guy right here, Al Harrington, he was really a part of that We Believe squad. So I just thought this video was perfectly fitting to review some Viola and check out that Chase Center. Well, let's get right to it. More importantly, y'all, let's get to the review of the Viola OG and see how it hits.
All right, guys. So we got the Viola OG right here by Al Harrington. Those are all the packaging dates and everything like that. It's at 30% THC. We're gonna see how it hits. I just think it's gonna look like some traditional OG, like most cannabis brands. But we're gonna see how this stuff is. I've smoked this Calabasas Kush and it was honestly awesome. So let's see how this Viola OG hits. All right, guys, so we just popped the top. And honestly, like, his OG looks super, super colorful. I like the color on it. It looks really nice. As you can see, it's still in that purple jar. So let's take it out and get on my North County Farms tray here. But the nugs look pretty nice. I do like them. They do look pretty good. It still looks like some classic OG, but it's got a little bit of some color in it. But let's see how this hits. We're going to smoke this right by the Oracle Arena, y'all. Got that shit rolled right over here near the BART. Pretty much the way that you would walk up to that old Oracle Arena right here. Go up these stairs right onto the BART overpass. Check out, go to the arena. See you guys a little POV right here. Well, boom, we are here on the BART overpass. Gate's still open. I'm gonna try to get right next to the Oakland Arena, formerly known as the Oracle Arena. Basically the house that Steph built. One of the biggest legends in the damn game today. So this is basically what the overpass looks like. Raider games, A's games, old Warriors games. People used to come over this. Now this is these guys. And we're looking to get a new stadium here in Oakland. So hopefully that happens. But this is that perspective of the overpass. Looks super tight. See if the gate's open. If not, I'm gonna have to go around. All right, guys, so the gates, unfortunately, on the overpass were closed. And this is as close as I can get to the arena. But that, there it is, there's the old Oracle Arena that Steph built a lot of memories in. And check out this next little clip and you'll see all those little memories right there before we spark this joint.
Green pass too low, but Curry recovers, shot clock winding down. Curry's gonna have to put it up, launches it up, shot clock. Oh, he knocks it down! Steph Curry with the shot clock expiring. It's gonna be a 24 second violation. No! By Green, Curry and Durant. Curry throws it up, Durant throws it down.
Basketball, you have certain teams that you are mentally stronger than.
Final seconds of the third. Curry putting on moves against Crawford. 1 second left, he fires. This is hard to believe.
All right, guys, and here's the other side of the arena. Still is used today for concerts and everything like that. God, is this place a legendary building. All right, guys, so we're back in the car. I wanted to get a little bit more up close and personal to the arena and smoke right in front of it, but fortunately that wasn't able to happen. Everything was pretty much locked, so there wasn't too much I can do about that. But let's smoke some of this Viola. Shout out Al Harrington, one of the former OG Warrior players and part of that We Believe squad. We gonna see how your OG hits right before this Warriors game. Gonna be showing you guys some nice views of Chase. I will not be smoking at the Chase Center. I'll be vaping because I'm not trying to get, you know, caught and stuff like that. So vaping is the easiest way. So I'll be showing you guys a little bit of that higher perspective of vaping. But when you vape in sporting arenas, just know the rules and everything like that. Know how to be cutty about it, because not every place is super lenient. Okay. Sparking this, some of this Viola OG here. Well, the first thing I definitely can notice off of it is it's got a nice, sweet taste to it. Kind of like feel that from Viola growers. After having the Calabasas Kush, it was like super sweet. So Viola definitely focuses on their terpenes. And for Al Harrington being a former NBA player, I really got a shout out to him to, you know, growing some good weed. Like, this isn't easy to grow. This stuff has some, you know, some pretty decent white ash right here. I'm actually pretty pleased with it. So, you know, he takes his time to learn about cannabis, how it really is. On top of that, he's the face to that brand for Viola. So he has growers that he's hiring to grow this type of stuff. Obviously, he's in the mix with it, but he's got good growers. So when you have these cannabis companies and you see these rappers and all these celebrities are the face of it, they're just the face of it. It's simple marketing at this point. Pretty much they're gonna have to choose a good grower group, and if they don't, it kind of makes their face and their image look bad. So that's why it's always important to have good growers, have people knowledgeable about cannabis. If you're not, just, you know, take the time to learn just about anything else. But oh my god, I'm loving this Viola OG. This is actually really, really nice stuff for sure. Definitely good smoke before a Warriors game. You know, just you want to be relaxed, chilling, watching the Warriors ball with that ball movement and everything like that. This is the perfect stuff for it. 30% too. 30% THC. High THC content. Smoking well. Smoking evenly. Not even canoeing. I like it. Definitely some good stuff. Check out Viola if you guys have it. It's run by a former NBA player. They just got an Iverson strain they just dropped. That's what I'm trying to find. That's definitely a dope one right there. But if you guys need Viola, it's pretty much in a lot of dispensaries near you. Just weed map it and you guys can find it. It is going to be some of that exclusive though. They usually want around $50 for this stuff. So if you're looking to get some Viola, you definitely want to bring a little bit of change with you. But I'm going to just smoke, you know, the middle portion of this. I'm going to give you my end perspective on it. And we all head out to Frisco and watch these Warriors ball, y'all. Let's hopefully they get the W. Yeah, feels? This is where I ended up having to pull up, y'all. All the way over here. Getting through the middle of this joint right here. But this is pretty much, I still kind of see it. Not really at all, though. But this is pretty much all the overflow parking. If events ever got, like, super crazy, people would just park here. All right, guys, so almost there with it. My end perspective is it's pretty good. I definitely want to give it, you know, around like a 7 out of 10 for sure. Just with like the taste and everything, the high's cool. It's like nice and chill, pretty much. Not like, you know, it's gonna like knock you out or anything like that. Love you chilling. Very, very interesting OG in terms of taste. Like, that's the most interesting OG I've ever tasted before, because very sweet. Most OGs don't taste that sweet. Kind of almost was similar to a sativa. It had that, you know, that OG kind of a little bit of that piney taste in there, but it was really a lot sweeter than I thought it was. So, all right, OG. It's a little bit of a surpriser right there. Other than that, I love this stuff. That's why I do give it a 7 out of 10. That's a good score. Anything below a 7 is horrible, pretty much. Like a 6, that's like mediocre, but at least a 7, I definitely can give it. Al Harrington, you guys are killing it. Thanks for being a part of the weed game. I really hope you do check this episode out at some point. But we're going to head over to the Chase Center, y'all, and show you guys the new digs that the Warriors got. Yeah.
right, High Area, we have arrived to the Chase Center. This is the first portion of it. Well, this thing looks dope though, with the video board and everything. Everybody's just lining up just to get into the game. All right, High Area, we have arrived here to the front of the Chase Center. We are here. This is such a grand entrance, but we're gonna show you guys the inside as well before we go in. Just arrived in the arena. We'll see the rest of the, how it looks. Right in that POV of the arena. This thing looks beautiful. Got it up in here. Put it up in your shoe. Hopefully it will work. Got my boy Draymond shooting right down there too. Getting the reps up before the game. I'll take a couple hits for you guys before and get set. In that game time mode. Looks like that's a High Area. Boys religious with it. This is how you get better. Repetition, 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 repetition. This is why we drop so many videos, y'all. Only keeps getting better every time. Bust down sandwich for the game. Right here at Big Sale Betty. We started off in the East Bay. Let's get it. Look who it is. The GOAT and the legend himself. Give him the moves. About to get the thunder this work. Boy, just missed. LOL.
Halftime, y'all, and you already know, you get lit here in High Area.
Oh, that boy just made it, wow.
I'm okay with that. No, I'm still fat.